So in this problem, we are exploring a very nice one-dimensional cellular automaton called Rule 110. So this is an automaton where states are only zeros and ones, and the transition is only considering the left and right neighbors. So for instance, if the state is one and the two neighbors are one, we switch to zero. But if the state is one and the left neighbor is one and the right neighbor is zero, we stay to the state one, and so on. So obviously there are 256 such automata, but Rule 110 is particularly interesting, and it has been proved to be Turing complete, which means that you can encode any computation with this automaton. And it is also very similar to John Conway's Game of Life. And the problem was stated as follows: you are given an initial configuration and a total number of time steps, which can be really huge, up to 260, and you have to compute the total number of ones in the final configuration. And we purposely mention the Game of Life in the problem statement as a clue to using hashLife algorithms to solve this problem. So hashLife is an algorithm invented by Bill Gosper in 1984, and it simulates the Game of Life for very large patterns and very large time steps using several ideas. So the main idea is to represent the pattern using quadtrees, and quadtrees of patterns of widths 2 to k. And you do hash counting of those quadtrees, which means that whenever subtrees are the same, they are physically shared in memory. Okay, and then given such a pattern, you can compute the center pattern of widths 2 to k minus 1s within 2 to k minus 2 steps forwards, because no information can come from the outside within that number of steps. And the idea is that you don't have to compute all the 2 to k minus 2 time steps. You can recursively use the result for the subtrees to compute the result for the whole tree. Okay, and you can do that very quickly. And in particular, you can memorize those results so that whenever you will have to compute the result for the same tree, you won't have to redo it. So this was described in this very nice paper, which was published in a physics journal. And a possible solution to that problem was to adapt hashLife algorithm to dimension one, which means that to use binary trees instead of quad trees. So for instance, if you have this configuration of length 16, you can represent it with a binary tree of two configurations of length 8, and themselves they are represented as two configurations of length 4, and so on. And if you do a maximal sharing of those binary trees, for instance, you can represent these configurations with only 7 different nodes instead of 15. And then you can compute the result, which is a configuration of length 8 within 4 time steps in the future, and you can do that in particular using only 3 new nodes by reusing previous nodes that you already built. Okay, and this is very efficient. For instance, if you consider this initial pattern and that huge number of steps, then you can get the answer very quickly, and actually you are only building a few hundred thousands of distinct nodes and a few hundred thousands of intermediate computations.